Most people in America understand the concept of medical rights. It is certainly a hot topic in the news today when we are facing communities of COVID. Communities of COVID are being redirected once again after the president literally said, if you have had this shot, if you have had this clearing, you can take your masks off. But at the same time, he's realizing that the principles of overseas, like Japan, when you have a cold and you put a mask on automatically and naturally, not only to protect yourself from other people, but also protect other people from your common cold, should be in place. The only problem, as someone who lived abroad in Japan and often occasionally had a cold and wore one of their cotton masks, was in truth it just kept you with your cold longer, because you're not breathing out into fresh air, you're still breathing in your, well, ill air. And that was just my humble observation, and I cannot prove that by any scientific information. What I can tell you is that people who have breathing problems or people who have depleted lungs are going to struggle with the masks on. But at the same time, what I do know about the Lord's house is that most of us need to have fresh air on. What I mean is that if we close ourselves into our home, we're using recycled air of our air conditioning units, and during a time when it's possible, we should definitely be airing out our homes by opening the windows, having the screens in, and allowing fresh air to flow freely into our home. Maybe just pushing it around with the air conditioning fan instead of actual air conditioning. The values of doing this to the homeowner are obvious in that you don't deplete your freon, which I believe is what it's called, that's still in air conditioning units to make air conditioning units use themselves and literally not abuse themselves during the months that we need to be protecting our water resources and protecting our energy and electricity. Obviously, the value of not using the fan technically on the air conditioning unit might be in saving energy and efficiency for our home. But on the other hand, my father was a great proponent of using electrical fans that were old-fashioned in windows. I can remember long before we had electrical air conditioning units in a traditional turn-of-the-century home like we lived in when we were growing up in the marvelous city of Illinois, was that we would actually put the fans in the windows instead of screens or with the screen to keep the bugs out, and we would use those big old-fashioned metal fans that were marvelous. And I'm so sad that eventually when they broke after 20, 30, 40 years, because that's how bulletproof they had been literally put together by manufacturers, that it could actually push the air all the way through the second story of our home based on where those fans were placed. We'd have a pull fan pulling the hot air out and a push fan bringing in cooler air. Now that's just a ridiculous explanation of what you could do to save electricity and energy to help the nation with its longevity. But openly, it's up to you.